Welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know about this video, Growth Excel function, watch the video till the end. And also, if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe it by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Today, friends, we have a topic that's called growth function in Excel. Let's begin. Now, see the growth function in Excel. It's basically an exponential, what we call as growth function in Excel, which is a statistical function, because that returns the what we call as the predictive exponential growth for a given set of data. Like, you know, for a given value of, let's say, x, it returns the predicted value of y. So the growth formula in Excel, it helps in financial and what we call as statistical analysis. Now, it helps to predict revenue targets. What? The revenue targets. It is also used as what we call as the regression. You can use it for regression analysis in Excel. So wherever the growth is calculated exponentially, this function fits an exponential curve to the data and returns the dependent value of y for the new value of the x. Now, what are the growth function, growth formula, like how does exactly that works? Okay, so over here itself, let me just write is equal to, just write growth. See, I've just written gr, it shows growth over here and says it returns the number in an exponential growth, that is trends matching known data points. Okay, like, so for growth formula in Excel, it is something like this. The equation that goes is y is equal to b into m raised to x. So it represents an exponential curve where the value of the y, this one, it depends upon the value of the x, and m is the best, the base which with the exponent x and b as the constant value. Now, known for the given relationship of y is equal to b into m raised to x, known the y is a set over here. The y is basically a set of y values in the data set, and it is required for the argument. The known for the x values, it is a set of x values in the data set, and the range value for the x should be same as what is the y's value. So it is optional argument, and if knowns x is omitted, it is assumed to be an array, that is 1, 2, 3. So that is the same size as known as y's. Now there is a new x. Now it is the value of the x for which we want to calculate the predictive corresponding value. So if we omit this value, the new value of x, that is the function, that the value as the same value of x, and based on that value, it returns the value of the y. So how to use this growth function in Excel? Let's start with the first example. We have a given data of sample with the given values of x and y, x and y values. Now we want to calculate the growth using the growth formula here. So the growth formula in Excel that we are supposed to use is growth, just write, is equal to growth, and you are going to enter over here the value of the y. See, it's showing known y's and then known x and known new x and then a constant, right? So let's write the known y value. Once you have written the known y value, then we will write what are the known x value, right? You see 31 is the outcome of this, right? Let's take another example here. So this was just the growth number that has been shown, considering this and this. Now, in this example, suppose let's say there is a company that has a revenue for the previous 10 years. The column A over here, it has year mentioned, and column B over here contains the revenue for each given year. So we want to calculate the revenue for the upcoming years. Based on the previously given data, we want to calculate the estimated revenue for the year 2019. How we are going to do that? Okay. So we have from year 2009 to 2019, and then we are given the revenues. So what is going to be the 2019 revenues based on the growth thing that we are assuming here? So over here it's 2,24,101, then 3 lakh, then 2,83,000. So you see there is a fluctuating amount that is moving here and there. Now, to predict the revenue for the year of 2019, we will be using the growth formula in Excel. Now, in this case, the new X value is the upcoming year, which is 2019. So the growth formula in Excel that we will be using will be, we'll say, growth. What are the known Y values? So that is from B3 to B12. Then the known X value from 2009 to 2018, that is, let's take full 20 till 2019, close the bracket. Once you do that, okay, we need a constant here. Sorry, this will be till A12, and then we need a new X. So we want to find this value. Now here's the answer, right? So in the year 2019, the company most probably will generate a revenue around closely around 291,181. And how is this exactly coming? So you can say over here, let's see, it can be an average. Let's see if it goes with the average or not. The average is coming down to 283,928. But as for the growth formula, it shows us 291. Obviously, there is a difference between both the formulas, and I've explained it very well. Now, in example number 3, suppose in a lab, we have an organic solution that contains bacteria that are growing exponentially in the solution, and they are increasing with the increase of the time given in the seconds. So we have the sample data for a number of bacteria with given time periods in seconds, and we need to estimate the bacteria growth after 150 seconds. The column A over here contains the time value in terms of seconds, and column B here contains the number of the bacteria that are multiplying exponentially. So we want to find for 150th second. So there are 30 seconds, so number of bacteria is this, for 40, and so on and so forth. So in order to estimate the increase or the growth in the product over the certain period of time, we'll be using this exponential growth function. We will select the range of known Y values, which is number of the bacteria growing with time, and known X values, which is the time period given in seconds. And the new X value is 150 seconds, for which we need to calculate the estimated increase in the number of the bacteria. So we'll use over here the round function, growth function. So we'll select known Y values as this, known X value as the time seconds, and the new X. So there we go, we have our answer, 393. Okay, so the total estimated number of the bacteria in the solution after 150th second will be approximately 393,436,223. So now, after discussing all of this, let's see what are the things that you need to remember about growth function in Excel. First, we can use the exponential growth function as an array, and when more than one new values of Y is computed. So in that case, the function is entered as in the array formula. Now in that case, the function is entered as an array formula by using the controlled shift and enter. Okay. So the growth function in Excel throws, you know, sometimes as the num error if any value of the known Y array is less than or equal to 0. But the growth function may show us a value error. There's a thing called value error if any of the known Y's or the new X values. Now, while using the exponential growth function in graph, we can often use the exponential option from the graph trend line option. So I hope that, you know, you have learned this very well. And if you have learned it and enjoyed watching this video, I would recommend you to please like, comment on this video, and subscribe to our channel for the latest update. Thank you.